A handful of key states will decide the US election, and if the polls are to be believed, Joe Biden has the edge in all of them. But in America's Midwest, Trump supporters are holding out hope.
There's an old country western saying, get the heck out of Dodge. But the residents of Dodge City, Kansas, are incredibly friendly, patriotic, and getting on with life as best they can.
Economy, we have to get it, back on track, get people working.
When coronavirus swept through, Ann and Chuck Taylor's roadhouse went from making $3,000 a day to just $400 a day. They say they trust Donald Trump to steer life here back to normal.
Trump loves this country. He loves the people of this country. He loves the Constitution.
I think he's done really well.
The nation's largest wheat producer and second largest beef producer, Kansas, is heavily dependent on the meatpacking industry, hit by outbreaks and shutdowns at the height of COVID. Farmer Mark Fisher says the president has been hands-on since taking office, especially during the health crisis.
He got involved out here with the farmers. He got involved with the coal miners in Pennsylvania. I mean, you name the industry. He's worked to try to get the packing houses back open so we can provide food for the American housewife and for the American families.
And while his COVID diagnosis hasn't played well for the president in the polls, in towns across the Midwest, it's only strengthened his support base.
From a grassroots perspective, we're helping and we're going to be helping him with his campaign even more.
In the capital, Topeka, 21-year-old first-time voter Paige Harding spends her weekends canvassing neighbourhoods, encouraging people to vote.
People look at the facts. Trump wins every time.
The president's words don't always resonate with her, but his actions do.
I feel like I'm numb to it. I'll see a tweet and I'm just like, oh, I don't even have a reaction anymore. And I'd rather have someone who I have to put up with these heinous tweets, but I'm seeing results in my pocket.
Sometimes he goes about it in a very odd way, but when it comes right down to it, he does care about people.
Donald Trump won Kansas comfortably in 2016. There's little doubt he will hold on to the state on November 3.
And there's another race taking place on polling day, which many people here believe is even more important than the presidential election. As the Republican Party fights to hold on to its majority in the Senate, Kansas is on the cusp of sending a Democrat to the Senate for the first time in nearly 90 years.
Senior GOP officials concede that as Trump trails in the polls, not helped by his coronavirus bout and controversial debate performances, losing control of the Senate is now a real possibility.
I think it's a terrifying thought. You know, we're pro-life, we're conservative, we love our Bibles and our guns, as, you know, the Democrats like to say about us, but we like our freedom.
In Kansas, Amelia Adams, 9 News.